All right, so I was actually amazed when this one came across because I recognized the name of the shop. It's called Flying High.
Yeah, 4x4.
With a letter N. When I was a kid, they were in the magazines and they had a monster truck.
I think this shop used to actually be so popular with the monster trucks that they had a little toy car.
People would come through Phoenix to go there just like they come through Dallas to go to Gas Monkey. Flying High was started in 1980. It was one of the top shops in the country for lift kits, monster trucks, and anything off-road related. That toy truck you're talking about was a replica of a monster truck the original owner, Mark Dye, built and named it Flying High. Jeremy, the current owner, was a huge fan of Flying High and jumped at the chance to buy the shop.
He bought it about 12 or 13 years ago, and he had big plans, and he just never got the thing off the ground. And the guy is, like, down to 6.5 to close it.
So it's Barrett Jackson week out here in Phoenix, and I'm like, hey, I'm gonna be at Barrett for a week. So I thought, what the heck? Fly Chris and Russell out, and if we can get the deal done, I'm making some money while I'm at Barrett Jackson.
I'm here for the duration anyways. I can knock, yeah, I know. I get to hang out for the whole build, man.
Love that. This is just low. There's nothing high about this except for you thinking if we can do this.
I don't know, man. This place has been here forever.
Yeah, it looks like it's been here forever, and it looks like they haven't done anything forever.
We pull up to the building, and it says Flying High. Yeah, they must be high thinking anybody's gonna pull in here and spend some money on any off-road vehicle here. The paint is faded. It's so dated, just like the brand has become.
I actually don't mind the logo.
No, I like it.
Hey, guys. Guys. Richard Rawlings.
Jeremy Hammer. Welcome to Flying High.
Russell, how are you?
We go in there, and I'm like, holy cow. I mean, this place looks huge.
This is where the money gets made on our lift bays.
So this is your number one guy?
This is Sage.
I haven't seen a lift like that in forever.
It was put in 1980.
Is it work, right?
It's been beat. That's from parts dropping down on it. Eventually, it builds up, and you can't put the lift down all the way.
Have you reinvested anything into the shop since you bought it?
Yeah.
We purchased a new computer up front, you know, a few things here and there, new jacks and that sort of thing.
Because I'm not seeing anything that's very modern. There's one car on one rack, and that's it. He's not fixing lifts. He doesn't have the money.
This is my only bay that's got the wide door.
Why not just open it all up? Why are there separate bays?
I don't know. I haven't touched any of that since we just left it.
It doesn't look like you've changed a whole lot at all since 2004.
When it comes down to, like, shop flow or workflow, it really didn't have anything. And the bays are separated, but for no reason at all. And then the bays are actually too small anyways to even fit these big trucks in. We got some big problems we got to fix.
How do you handle alignments and stuff if you're doing all this front-end work?
We run them to another shop.
What about tire machines? Like, what size can you go up to?
I can mount and balance a 24-inch rim.
Where's the balancer?
Right over here.
That's not next to that?
Nope.
That balancer, that old one?
The old one.
So you just mount it here and then you roll it?
Roll it over there.
So two lifts, and that's enough with the amount of work you have now.
We have one lift. The other lift doesn't work.
All right, here we go. That already doesn't look.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. No, okay.
So at no point do you think that this warranted getting looked at?
Oh no, we looked at it. We just couldn't fix it. You think you got a good business, you think you're doing everything right, and then they have somebody come in and show you how janky your lifts are and how dangerous and how unsafe that is. It's definitely an eye-opener for me.
This brand is 38 years old, and it's due for a comeback, and I believe with some careful planning, it can be revived. Here's the way the deal works. If you decide to take a deal, which I'm guessing this is gonna be about 225 grand that I've gotta put in, I'm willing to put in the money, contacts, time, energy, and make it happen. The hard knocks of it is, if you don't make it, this is gonna be Flying High by Gas Monkey.
I'm bricks about it. I'm leveraging against something that I've had for 12 years and put a lot into it, and I don't think there's any other way.
It'll be my way or the highway, starting the second you side okay.
If we don't make it at the end of 2018, we're losing Flying High anyway.
All right, so?
I'm ready to do it.
All right, cool. You now got a monkey on your back. And now I'm the boss of Flying High.
There's nothing that we can do in these garages without getting the junk out. Oh, baby, make no sense. We're dealing with the building that's over 38 years old. So I got Rodeo Plumbing in here taking out this old sink and the plumbing to it.
There they are.
We need it. Jeremy's friends came in. I mean, it was like a little army in there. They're helping us every square inch, trying to get all of these old parts and junk and dust and dirt and everything out.
When we see a lift like this, it's a big headache. This has hydraulic fluid in it. It's got airlines. It's got such a complicated infrastructure. So we got the guys from Lift Pro in here to give us a hand. We have to take these 6-foot cylinders out of the ground. In order to do that, they have to grind there so I can lift that whole thing off and take it off with the forklift. Then we're gonna have to suck out the hydraulic fluid that's in there, put cement in it. It's a big process.
How bad are these lifts?
When should they have been replaced?
Condemned years ago.
Condemned years ago.
With all the debris and dirt and everything else, nuts and bolts dropping down there, you're supposed to clean this stuff out. You're supposed to inspect and maintain these things on a weekly basis.
These should have been condemned years ago. And you had your guys working underneath it.
I'm ashamed of myself. That could have killed somebody, so I'm just glad these guys are here.
After we remove the lifts, it's time to tear down the walls. All right, Chris, lock it down. I'm gonna kill 2 walls with 1 fork. One wall is down, the other one's halfway down. We're ahead of the game.
We have a lot to do today. The retail space still needs to be completed, and now after the stucco's dry, we can paint the exterior of the building. And for this shop, I have some specialized equipment coming in. Flying High Specialty is working on trucks and off-road vehicles. So I got them some tire fitting equipment from Ranger.
Oh!
This tire safety cage costs $485, but it's priceless when you factor in what it does. It actually cuts down on the potential liability within this garage.
Because of the off-road vehicles, the trucks,
even the buses that are all around here, this will save lives. Basically, when you're inflating anything that's like the military tires, the off-road tires, what can happen is sometimes these wheels are multi-piece and they can explode. And so what you want to do is you're going to roll the wheel into here, and then the technician can fill it safely from a distance. Back in the 80s, a lot of deaths in shops were because of tires exploding. It was something like from 1978 to 1987, there was 674 injuries. 174 of them were fatalities.
Good call on this, Chris. Yeah. You killed it with this one.
There it is.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my goodness.
Stuck in the parking lot.
Look at that.
Looks a little better driving up, huh?
It was overwhelming. Get out of the truck and see what these guys have done. I couldn't hold back. I tried, but they started to flow a little bit.
All right, it's already happening.
Thank you, sir.
He literally left him in there.
You can tell they were genuinely excited.
So excited, they left Dawson in the back of the truck.
Sorry, Dawson.
Oh, man.
That was your boys there. I didn't do that.
Yeah, we're all good.
So as you can tell, Flying High's what we're known for since 1980. I figured why mess with it.
I'm a fan of the Stars and Stripes, but I just didn't like the other logo when we came in. And I think this establishes the fact that it's been around forever, gonna be around forever.
Cleaned up the whole facade here. We ended up reshifting everything, giving you a nice center entrance. The outside's got to look good or nobody's going to see the inside. Since the front lot was a mess, we had Sunstar seal coating, seal, and stripe the whole front lot for you guys.
So here we go.
Oh, my God.
Whoa.
So what do you think, guys?
Holy moly.
Wow, wow, wow.
We didn't even really know what we were working with until those walls came out.
Correct. Now you got a shop.
Service to Service came out. They used DMAX to grind the floors, and Westcoat did the product. These are killer. Keep this place looking this good, and customers will love it. We reached out to Bailey Industrial, and this is a fab table that I don't even have at my shop yet. You've got a bandsaw back there. You've got a pipe bender. You've got a work table area. And when it comes to welding and plasma cutting, Lincoln Electric, they're my go-to people. How much can you make in this one bay?
If this is a fabricating bay and you got a good technician, I'm saying $5,000 a week, $20,000 a month. You know, lifts, it's $800 a day. Both of these lifts hold 10,000 pounds.
Wow.
That awesome Quattro lift over there that also has the alignment tower on the front, that can do 12,000 pounds.
And these lifts lift. Not like the ones you had before.
True.
Safely.